Welcome back to Anish Kar Details Vlog. Today we are going to discuss a new topic that is based on Python C. Today we are going to discuss one of the output question based on list. Okay, based on list. This is one of the common topic in CBSE class 11th IPM Computer Science. Here I will show you how to solve this type of question in very easy manner. See, first we can check the code. After that I will show you how to solve this. See, find the output of the following code. L is equal to, here one of this is nothing but a list declaration. L is equal to 100 200 300 400 500, and L1 is equal to L of 2 colon 4, and print the value of L1. After that, L2 is equal to L of 1 colon 5, print the value of L2. Okay, see, before going in detail, first you have to understand what is list. See, list is nothing but a data structure used for storing the elements. Okay, it is the, see, in list we can store heterogeneous element. Heterogeneous, what is heterogeneous? Heterogeneous means we can store different data types elements. Different data types elements we can store in list. Okay, and list is a mutable data structure. It is a mutable. What is mutable? Mutable means we can modify the data elements. The elements in data list we can modify. Yeah. Square bracket list elements, everything is treated under a square bracket. And the elements inside the list is separated by using commas. Okay, that's all about list. See, first you have to understand, this is nothing but a list declaration. L is equal to 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. Okay. Then L1, they are declaring another list. L1 is equal to L of, what is L? Our previous list. L of 2 colon 4. See, here you have to understand one point. Each and every list element having their own index. Okay. In list, basically, there are two types of index are there. One is positive index, another one is negative index. Okay. One is positive index, another one is negative index. See, basically the positive index is starting from left to right, and negative index is starting from right to left. See, here we are, I am going to mark the positive index. See, I told you each and every element having their own index. So positive index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, L of 2 colon 4. Here you have to understand, this indicates the start index. This indicates the stop index or ending index. Okay, ending index. So L of L1 having the elements L of 2 colon 4. So starting index is 2 and ending index is 4. Here one more point you just keep in your mind. Ending index 4 means that value will be excluded. So it will take the value up to 3 only. So it will take the value starting with 2. Starting with 2 means index 2. 0, 1, 2. That means starting with 300. The value 300. Up to 4. 4. Means this value, but that value will be excluded, so it will print up to 400 300 comma 400. That will be the value of this statement that will be stored into L1. Okay, then if you are printing the value of L1, you will get the output this, you will get this output. Okay, so if you are printing the value of L1, the output will be 300 comma 400. Okay, I hope it's clear. Next we are moving to the next statement. L2 is equal to L of 1 is to 5. What is the meaning of this statement? Starting index is 1, ending index is 5. So starting index 1 means 0, 1. Starting with the 200 up to 5. But here we are having the index up to 4. So it will print till last. So it will print the elements starting from 1 to the end. So you will get the value. So you will get the value like this, starting with L of 1 is to 5. 1 means 200. Okay, then up to 5 means up to 4 it will print. The 5, that last value will be excluded. So 200, then 300, then 400, then 500. Okay, so that value will be stored into L2. Then if you are printing the value of L2, the same value will be printed here, 200, 300, 400 500. Okay, I hope it's clear. If you have any doubt regarding this topic, you can put it in our comment section, then you will get the answer. Thank you all. Thank you for watching. And subscribe to this vlog.